So my first question, Dr. Aswal and Mr. Pant and Dr. Mukesh Kumar, is that could we have your views on what do you think would be the two or three most important initiatives that the industry can explore for smart, sustainable, and inclusive growth of the sector? Dr. Aswal, if you could please kindly say your word, then Mr. Pant, and then finally Dr. Mukesh Kumar.
Yeah, very good afternoon to all of you. Circular economy, as has been explained very well, that after the end of life of a product, we need to reuse it. Or in simple term, let us say that any waste material need to be utilized. I come from National Physical Laboratory, which is the National Measurement Institute of India. And we have got a lane in front of us, a road in front of us, known as the Dr. K S Krishnan Road. What I see that anywhere, anytime, anybody makes a building, new building, all the concrete materials, waste material are disposed of in that lane. So we have to have a complete knowledge that what we discuss in big conferences and what actually happens on the ground, they are the two different things. Now, when we analyze it, why this happens, and if you remember recently for the plastic waste, since we could not recycle it, we have to ban single plastic use. Similarly, long ago, there was a biomass converting into the electricity that was not profitable, and then finally, again, you know the farmers are still burning the crops. One should know that anything which has become waste at some point of time, to use it into the, to make it useful for the, some useful products, the money need to be spent on that. And until unless that part is taken care of, I think the circular economy is not going to be successful. And when we talk about the circular economy, first of all, why the so much of waste is generated? And most of the time, we'll realize that the quality of the products are not essentially correct. And that is responsible essentially because we do not have an essential ingredient of understanding the quality of the product. And when we talk about the quality of the product, essentially it comes back to the measurement. Say, for example, when we are making a good quality cement. Now, cement quality, some say it is good, some say it is bad. They need to be compared. Compared with respect to what? So they are a certified reference material. So from NPL point of view, along with the National Cement Board, we have come up with the certified reference material known as the Bharatiya Nirdeshak Dravya. And those BNDs need to be used as a standard reference material, certified reference material. Any time in many places we import these certified reference materials. Okay, so one of the suggestions would be the durability of the product can be enhanced if we have got the correct kind of measurements, and we should use the appropriate certified reference material, number one. Number two, when we are recycling the product, the economic factors need to be put in place. As I have already given many examples that the business is not profitable. And when the products are coming out of it, they should again ensure the quality of it. Again, the certified reference materials are required for that. So these are the, some of the things if you want to really grow it. And third most important thing is that the awareness among the masses. Unfortunately, if you see our education system, we do not talk about the quality infrastructure. And quality infrastructure means conformity assessment. And conformity assessment means whatever I am saying, whatever value I am giving, it is that value with the desired uncertainty. And therefore, quality infrastructure, it is not my definition, it is a definition of United Nations Industrial Development Organization, UNIDO, that first of all, you should have a correct measurement. Then anytime you make a product and process, that should be as per the standard. And anybody who is doing it, that should be accredited by third party. That is called accreditation. And in any case, If somebody does not follow all these quality infrastructure, there should be a legal methodology who should impeach the people. So what has just happened that this quality infrastructure, the measurement, that is National Physical Laboratory, the standard, that is the BIS, Bureau of Indian Standards, accreditation, the QCI and its one, and the legal methodology, Ministry of Consumer Affairs. The link is still weaker. So that need to be made more stronger so that we are able to comply the good quality product and process in the country.
Thank you, Dr. Pan.
Thank you, Samaddar Saab. I think Dr. Aswal has already made very important points which would complement what I would like to say. What Mr. Samaddar